Hello everyone, I'm Ian Brereton from the Centre for Advanced Imaging at the University of Queensland. Welcome to this course on MRI. Together over the next 2 weeks, we will explore the quite amazing science of magnetic resonance imaging. MRI is an imaging modality that provides exquisitely detailed information about the structure and function of the human body. It allows visualization of diseased and damaged tissue and helps us to learn how the body functions when healthy and when unwell. MRI is based on a phenomenon known as nuclear magnetic resonance, or NMR, which was discovered in the late 1930s and early 1940s. For the next 30 years or so, NMR was developed into a powerful tool for the analysis of the chemical structure of materials in solution and in their solid form. In the mid-1970s, the ability of NMR to produce a spatial image of water molecules was discovered, and this led to the imaging modality we now know as MRI. There have been no less than 8 Nobel Prizes awarded to scientists who contributed to the development of MRI and its associated technologies, an indication of how important this modality has become. In just 40 years since its early development, when blurry images of objects like fruit were produced, followed by the first fuzzy images of the human body, MRI has become a crucial diagnostic imaging modality that provides our doctors and clinicians with a vast array of information about our health. It is also a key technology for biological research, enabling scientists to study in great detail the function of living systems from small plants to animals to humans. We can perform MRI scans in any direction and almost in real time, and can produce extraordinarily detailed images of the body. Since MRI does not use ionizing radiation, it is very safe and we can scan as many times as necessary. Not only do we obtain information about the physical structure of our bodies, but we can use MRI to measure functional connections between different parts of organs. We can measure networks of neurons in the brain, for example, visualize veins and arteries, and detect regions of diseased tissue, such as in stroke, multiple sclerosis, and cancer. Clinicians used MRI to obtain information about the health of our bones and cartilage that will help in early diagnosis of arthritis and other joint disorders. Cardiologists can view cine images of the heart to help in the diagnosis of cardiac disease. These are just a few examples of the impact that MRI has had on diagnostic imaging and demonstrate its importance to our healthcare. In this course, we will introduce you to some of the fundamental concepts that describe the physics of MRI. We describe the origin of the MRI signal and how it is detected, and how the signal can be spatially encoded. We will describe how the various components of the scan are put together to build a sequence that produces MRI data. We will examine some of the important properties of the nucleus and how they change during a sequence, and how we can exploit these properties to distinguish one tissue type from another and alter the contrast between tissues in the image. We will also describe the construction of the MRI scanner itself and some of the factors we need to consider for its safe operation. So what happens if your doctor sends you to have an MRI scan? We will describe the procedure that Brian experienced during his visit to the MRI clinic so that you know what to expect if you need to undergo a scan. I hope you enjoy this introduction to MRI, that we answer some of your questions about how MRI works, and that you complete the course with a desire to learn more about the fascinating science of magnetic resonance imaging.